Omega Telecom Station, and we're here with Akilah Unique and Distinguished Scholars. Lita, give us a little information about what we're doing here today, and speak to the camera, please.
Well, first we'd like to welcome you to the Akilah Unique and Distinguished Scholars Telethon. We're here today to raise $15 million to purchase a facility that will house up to 250 at-risk youth, and we need your help. Please pick up your phones and call 1-877-777-0825 or 954-929-7010. Or to pledge your support, you can go to our website, www.akilahresidential.com.
I'm Michelle Ellis from Omega Television Network, and I'm here to interview Mr. Vic Jean-Claude here at the Akilah Residential Facility. Hi, Mr. Jean-Claude, how are you? Good. Thank you so much for being here. We're really looking forward to the things you're doing at the Akilah Residential Facility. Just want to ask you a few questions. I know you have four kids here at the facility and at the school, and thinking about the new school that's coming. What is your experience so far at the Akilah Christian Military Academy?
My experience with Akilah hasn't been anything less than amazing. My kids have been here for about 5 years. The discipline factor, the academic factor has served them well. So it's definitely an amazing experience as well.
Excellent. Well, with four kids here, why did you choose Akilah Christian Academy as opposed to regular school?
Well, I've always gone to private school all my life, most part. And I find the classroom size, the small classroom size, the one-on-one type of teachers, and the whole family network, it's definitely a plus for having four kids. So my time is crazy.
Well, I know that you are an excellent father and always looking forward to speaking to a parent that's so engaged in school. What are some of the things that Akilah have brought in aftercare and in academic excellence that you find that you would not have received if you were in the other school?
The main point that I like personally, after you get home from work and doing homework, it kind of gets a little crazy. So here at Akilah, aftercare, they really do versus public school. It's kind of automatic. Make sure homework is done, so I can come up, go home, dinner, refresh my homework, done for
you. Excellent. Well, one of the things that we're looking for here is the residential facility is about to launch into a major new endeavor. And what do you think, being what we are here today, will bring with the new 250-bedroom facility, the increase in the community outreach, the things that we're doing to facilitate you donating to what we're, why should someone even think about donating to a kid and the new school?
Well, if you have a farm and if you have any concern about the basement and the direction that they're going, rather than the direction that they should be going, you should donate. It keeps kids on the streets, keeps the system, learn life lessons. So to me, it's all at this point, especially in my house. It's just wrong. So every facility like a kid residential the service of these kids.
Thank you so much.
It's time Ms. Audrey Rodriguez.
Hello everybody. I would like to take this opportunity to thank you so much for your donations and contributions. And we're trying to raise the $15 million. Believe me, to God, $15 million is like 15 cents. Again, thank you so much for your contributions.
Omega TV station, and I'm interviewing a teacher educator, Ms. Martin from Akilah Christian Academy.
Hello, my name is Ms. Martin. I'm an educator teacher here at Akilah Christian Military Academy. My duty is to ensure that all kids are educated in a safe, non-inclusive environment.
Excellent. Now, why is it important to have Bible study and Bible class?
As Christians, everything we do, we should start off with God, but I think it is important for the students in the morning to have Bible and morning prayer because it helps put their day into perspective and allow them to see.
Oh, very good. What is the most important factor for children to learn in a small environment?
Well, in a smaller classroom setting, most of the children are able to get one-on-one as well as whole class environments. I think it gives them confidence, the willingness to learn, and they're also eager to participate. But at the same time, the teacher's able to teach the students to master the skill as opposed to being in public school where they're being taught to a test.
The new facility is going to be beautiful. Can you give me some opinion that you have on what you think it's going to be like?
Well, honestly, I hope it goes well at the new facility, especially with the residential part. I think it will benefit a lot of children, not only from our program, but across the United States will benefit from the facility because there's none other like it. But not only that, the public, the parents, and the students will all have input with everything that goes on at the new facility. So I'm really looking forward to it.
Thank you so much. I'm Michelle here at Omega TV Station, and we really need your donation. Please call 1-877-777-0825. Do you have any last comments you'd like to give?
Yes. I'm Ms. Martin, a teacher educator at Aquila Christian Military Academy. I think it is very important that we educate our leaders of tomorrow today. So I'm asking you as a community to help us in purchasing a $15 million
for Bring Child Institute and its staff members for $250. Thank you.
Hello, Aquila Christian Telethon. My name is Sure I can help you with that. You like to make a $500 donation? Sure, hold on a moment, please. Nancy from Debbie Jr. Falls, and would like to make a $500.
Michelle from Omega TV Station, and I'm here with the Major. Could you introduce yourself?
Hi, how are you? I'm Major Marissa Madison. I'm the lead drill instructor at Aquila Christian Military Academy. I'll also be one of the drill instructors at the new residential facility, Aquila Unique and Distinguished Scholars.
Great. What drew you to the position?
Well, my desire to work with kids. I take a look at the way our kids, our youth in society right now, the direction that they're in right now as far as their behavior, their mannerism. And I pretty much was raised very strict, I look at myself and how I was raised, and I look at the way things are right now with the kids. A lot of kids are coming from single family homes. A lot of kids are being put out of school. They're high school dropouts. They don't complete, you know, the grades and the.
How long have you been working in this capacity?
8.5 years.
Good.
Yes.
What drew you to the position?
Well, just a strong desire to want to work with kids, especially our young youth today. Just taking a notice in the direction where the kids are headed is, I mean, it's, to me, my personal opinion, it's they're lacking the mannerism, the character, the morals, and positive attributes that I felt like were lost somewhere down the line.
Do you feel as if what you have done has been a positive impact on the kids, the school, and your community?
Yes, ma'am, I do. The reason I feel that way is because I feel anything, anyone could bring to a child in a positive way, I mean, instill positive attributes such as honor, respect, integrity, you know, into a child. I feel it's a great help to the society, to the community, to the schools. You know, the kids, believe it or not, as much as they run away from discipline, they really, really want discipline. They need discipline, and they just don't realize, you know, how important discipline in life is. You know, as they get older, they start to realize it, but as a young child or a young youth, you know, they just look at it as they don't want to be told what to do, but they need that positive guidance. They need that positive structure.
What would you like to do that you have not implemented yet?
Well, I would like to see a residential facility. You know, currently we're here and it's a day facility, it's a day school, and I would like to see us, you know, be able to actually function and have a residential facility, a larger facility, a facility designed, you know, to have kids come and we continue daily on a daily basis, 24 hours a day, you know, that regimen, that structure, that counseling, that mentoring. That's what I would like to see.
Wow. Well, what is the most rewarding part?
Most rewarding part of my job for me would be when I see my kids walk across that stage. May it be the kindergartners graduating or the eighth graders graduating, and definitely my seniors. When my seniors walk across that stage, it's a feeling that's very overwhelming. once they graduate and they go off into their careers or whatever their endeavors are, they would come back. They would come back and they would talk to me. They would shake my hand and congratulate themselves, actually, and apologize to me for their behavior when they were there. If there were some that were completely out of control, they realize, you know, they realize what we were there for, what I was there for, what everyone in Aquila was trying to do when they were being very rebellious and not receptive to what we. And it makes me feel proud. And out of all the students that I've dealt with over my 8.5 years, just to have one come back, it touches me and it makes everything to me.
I feel the kids gain the most.
Where do they gain the most? I can go on with that question also. I feel that they gain the most better self-esteem. They come day to day or they walk away feeling a lot more proud of themselves, of their accomplishments. A lot of the kids accomplish the smallest task and it's a big deal to them. And I make a big deal out of it. Because a lot of kids have been told, you know, most of their life that they can't do this and they can't do that, or they'll never amount to this or never amount to that. Very negative things have been said, you know, to some of the kids, not all of them, but some of them. And I mean, just that positiveness that I can instill or implement in their day-to-day life, it really matters. And they walk away feeling proud of themselves. And I feel proud of them. But just to have one student come in and do one push-up, but at the end of the week, they're able to do 5 push-ups, that's an accomplishment. I push them, I make them see that they can persevere. They have that heart inside of them. They just need to dig deep for it, you know, reach for it. And when they do and they accomplish it, it's awesome. It's an awesome feeling.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
Now, is there any last comment you have about why we should purchase this $15 million facility?
Yes, I do. Viewers, I ask of you to kindly try to become a part of our vision, a part of helping us save our young youth of today by donating whatever you can. It doesn't matter if it's $1, $5, $10, whatever your heart desire, whatever you feel is a contribution to.
For all donations over $5,000, you will receive a direct link from our website to yours, as well as your company's logo and name on all of our promotional items. So please, pick up your phones right now.
Welcome back. I'm Michelle with Omega TV Station, and we're here continuing our interview with the Lieutenant. Introduce yourself to our audience.
My name is Lieutenant Nguyen from Aquila Military Christian Academy.
Lieutenant Nguyen, how long have you been working with the kids in this capacity?
I've been working with the kids in this capacity for right around 6 years. In the worst of circumstances, and bring them up to a level where they...
What do you feel the kids gain the most from this?
They gain the most from this program, not only the skills to enter the world and be an effective part of it, but they receive the amount of discipline and leadership training that our corporate CEOs, managers, leaders...
Well, thank you so much, Lieutenant Nguyen. We really need you to donate to this facility. We really need this $15 million facility for our children. Just please donate 1-877-777-0825.
Please donate today and give us a chance to provide a better future for these children.
Or you can mail your donation to 2835 Madison Street in Hollywood, Florida 33020. We would like to give a special thank you to Mr. Vic Jean Claude from Innovative Multimedia and Mr. Kirk Francis from Progressive Real Estate 2000 for your donation. Again, our number is 1-877-777-0825 or 954-929-7010. Our operators are standing by.
My name is Audrey Rodriguez. I am the founder and principal of Aquila Christian Military Academy. I opened up Aquila was to work with students that were considered at risk, not only in academic achievement, but also spiritual development, low self-esteem, and motivation. Our vision for the new school has superseded our expectations here at Aquila. What we would like to do right now is to open up a residential school in Sunrise. On 98,000 square feet of land, we would like to house residential students to help them be stable, help them have motivation skills, help them with spiritual development, career development, sports. This will be a co-ed dorm, army, both males and females. We're asking for your support and your help to make this dream come true. We need your support, whether you're a doctor, a lawyer, we need all type of child advocate agencies, all of my politicians, my legislators, we need you. We need you to come forth and help our children. We're all considered at risk. We have to pass children who have no spiritual development. We don't know where their minds are coming. We don't know what their career advancements are. We need your support in making this a reality and giving them the love and stability and security that they need. Every child is entitled to happiness. Every child is entitled to be loved and even to be disciplined. And we're calling for your support. We're losing our children by the zip codes, not just by the counties or the states, but by the zip codes. There are parents out there that need our help. I know you do. I know what we go through here. And we've gotten to the point we just don't have enough space here for counseling. These children don't need counseling once a week or once every 2 weeks. They need it every day. They need critical thinking skills. They need family dynamics to teach them how to get along in a family. They need to learn if plan A don't work, they have plan B. If A and B don't work, then there's God. God has to be before everything we do. And a lot of kids don't know this, and we need this. They are our future. They're the product of tomorrow, not stock markets, not whether we're Democratic or Republican. These are our children that we're talking about. And I'm interested in helping you save your child, and we need your support.
Thank you for donating to Akilah's Vision.
Thank you for calling Akilah. Mama Sweet Note. Okay. How much support are you donating today, sir?
I'm appealing to you to come forward to help us support this vision that we have here at Akilah Unique and Distinguished Scholars. Please come out and support our children. There are several ways that you can send in donations. You can call us at 1-877-777-0825. Or you can click on to www.akilahresidential.com and click on the button Donate. Or you can mail us at 2835 Madison Street, Hollywood, Florida, 33020. Here is what we're asking you to help support us with. This is Akilah's Unique and Distinguished Scholars. Here we have an administration building that has 59 executive offices. At the bottom of the floor, we would like to gut the buildings so we can have a regular day school. Over here, we have a cafeteria with two full commercial kitchens that house 180 in the cafeteria. We have a gym here that we can service 500 people for event plannings and all our sports activities. We have building 2, 3, and 4, which are residential facilities that can house up from 100 to 240 students, not including a swimming pool and tennis courts. This is the vision right here to help at-risk children. We need your help, we need your financing, and your support to make this dream come true. We're branching out in faith to raise $15
million. Thank you so much. Thank you. Have a good day. God bless. Mr. Jean-Claude from Innovative Multimedia Company, donate $15 million.
Help us with the vision that you see here. We need your support. There are three ways in which you could send in donations. You can call 1-877-777-0825. You can also click on to www.akilahresidential.com and click on donations if you please. All your support is greatly needed. Oh, and there's our address at 2835 Madison Street, Hollywood, Florida, 33302. Your donations are greatly appreciated. We need you to be part of this legacy, part of this vision to save our children.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for bringing Child Institute and its staff members the $250. Thank you.
Hello, Akilah. This is a telephone. My name is Ishara. You're acting at the $500 donation. I have Nancy from Debbie's Uniforms. I'd like to make a $500.
Vision. Yes, we'd like to remain anonymous.
today. Thank you for donating. Thank you so much.
Wonderful, Miss Brady. I'm Michelle, and I'm just urging you, please donate. We must
hear from Omega Television Station, and we're here with Akilah Unique and Distinguished Scholars. Give us a little information about what we're doing here today, and speak to the camera, please.
Well, first, we'd like to welcome you to the Akilah Unique and Distinguished Scholars Telethon. We're here today to raise $15 million to purchase a facility that will house up to 250 at-risk youth, and we need your help. Please pick up your phones and call 1-877-777-0825 or 954-929-7010. Or to pledge your support, you can go to our website, www.akilahresidential.com. Our operators are
standing. Thank you for donating to Akilah Vision.
Thank you for calling Akilah.
Madison Street in Hollywood, Florida, 33020. We would like to give a special thank you to Mr. Vic Jean Claude from Innovative Multimedia and Mr. Kirk Francis from Progressive Real Estate 2000 for your donation. Again, our number is 1-877-777-0825 or 954-929-7010. Our operators are standing by, founder Ms. Audrey Rodriguez.
Hello, everybody. Take this opportunity to thank you so much for your donations and contributions, and we're trying to raise the $15 million. Believe me, to God, 15 again, thank you so much for your contributions.
Hello, Akilah
Thank you so much for bringing Child Institute and its staff members for $250. Thank you.
Hello, Akilah.
$15 million, but we know that you can help.